We're shaking, folks. Back with another reaction. Back with some more Grace Jones. And we're back with the title track from her 1981 album, Nightclubbing. I do already have a sense for the, let's say, the adult atmosphere and the perhaps naughty euphemisms that were particularly in play on Pull Up to the Bumper. But I did mention, you know, in that reaction, I'm not quite sure, you know, what level to take some of these phrases that I'm seeing in the titles, and a few people commented, but Philip was like, if there's any ever doubt, like, just think that Grace Jones equals sauciness, like, the, you know, that's what you should expect. So, with that in mind, nightclubbing as a term and as a concept, it sounds like, again, you know, adult, like, late night dancing on the dance floor, people flirting, people being sexy, getting hot for one another, and perhaps, you know, what happens after that. So yeah, it feels like maybe the life, not just the actual experience of, you know, listen to dance music late night at a club and, you know, a darkened room with other attractive people and so on, but the whole, you know, paraphernalia, both socially and psychologically, that goes with that. So that would be my expectation. Again, these title speculations are just that. They're just a way to get my brain working in advance of hearing a tune. But yeah, I have been thinking about the title of the album a little bit, so given the first two tunes and given some comments that I've heard, that's what I would expect. I do think I'm going to have to let her out before I start this video. She is very restless, so I apologize, but yes, I understand. Off into the night, you rapscallion. But yes, so let's give this a go. This is Grace Jones. This is her tune, Nightclubbing, from the album of the same name, 1981. It's a beat a bit deeper and heavier than I was expecting.
Nightclubbing, where what's happening? Nightclubbing, where a nice machine.
Guitar work just simmering.
Nightclubbing, we're walking through town. Nightclubbing, we walk like a ghost.
Like
we learn dances, brand new dances, like the nuclear bomb.
Which we just also heard. It's definitely like a different approach angle to the concept than I was thinking. In some ways it feels like it's in the same territory I was expecting, but from a different angle. Certainly sonically. A bit of like alien feel to it also. On some level, again, I feel like there were maybe some themes that I was expecting, but yeah, sonically it was very different, and ultimately, you know, it felt like a, like it was, the tune itself was less like what you would hear at a nightclub than maybe I was expecting, which, you know, again, knowing the people mentioning there's, you know, lots of soul, lots of funk, some different flavors, I wasn't expecting it to be like a four to the floor dance tune or anything, but yeah, I don't know, it had this like languid, a bit mysterious, you know, like had a bit of a swagger to it, but it was deeper and heavier than I expected it to be. So sonically that was a really interesting one, and again, it seems like her music is like, you know, it's outside the lines, it's doing things that, you know, are not, you know, there's like bomb explosion sounds and seashore sounds and little ghost synths and things that sort of fit in with the lyrics, where it's like, you know, it feels like it's meant to express certain ideas or tones on multiple levels. So yeah, still getting a sense of not only her lyrical content, but of, you know, the production just of this album. And, you know, again, I understand that over the course of someone who has multiple albums, you're going to get some different evolutions, some different, you know, directions and so on. So yeah, still getting a sense for this album, never mind her music more generally, but I am finally glad to be going through this. Again, it sat in the like on deck area of my music computer for a while, but there's just so many deep dives that, you know, it just kept getting pushed back and pushed back, but we're here now. And indeed, a number of people, both who were already following the channel and at least a handful who I think found it through the first couple, or found the channel through the first couple Grace reactions. I'm excited that there's people keen to talk about her music. Again, as someone who only knew her in a very limited sense through her acting, it's really cool to start to get a fuller sense of, you know, who she was as like a cultural icon and force in the 80s, when, again,